Good morning, children. Saira, how are you all? I hope all of you are doing good, isn't it? So today we are going to revise with our value education subject. Okay? So one class has been taken for you in value education. Yes? So we are going to continue with the second chapter. Okay? I hope all of you will pray every day, isn't it? The first chapter was also about your prayer. Yes, children? So what is prayer? Prayer is talking to God. You are talking to God, right? When you close your eyes and ask God for something or thank God for whatever you have received, that is prayer. Okay? Do you know, children, prayer has a power? Yes, prayer has a power, and in the second lesson we are going to see the power of prayer. Okay, so are you ready? Let us go into the second chapter. Power of prayer. Once there lived a boy named Hari who loved God very much. Once there lived a boy named Hari who loved God very much. He used to sing, dance, and play with his friends and make everyone happy. He used to sing, dance, and play with his friends and make everyone happy. His father was a scholar and did not like it. His father was a scholar and did not like it. Come, Hari, sit and study. Don't waste your time. Okay? So in a village, there lived a boy named Hari. So what was the name of the boy? He was Hari and he loved God very much. So how many of you like God? Everyone likes God, isn't it? So Hari loved God very much. He was a very good boy. Okay, he used to sing, dance, and play with his friends and make everyone happy. Okay, but his father, who was a scholar. What do you mean by a scholar? A learned person. Okay, he wanted Hari to become studious. That is, he wanted Hari to sit and study. So he asked Hari to come and sit down to study. Okay, now let's see what's happening. He thought, if I send Hari to the town, he will learn good manners. So Hari sent him to his uncle's home. So Hari's father sent him to his uncle's home. I have got freedom here, so I can pray to God for a long time, said Hari. I also get more time here to help and serve others. So Hari was sent to his uncle's house to learn discipline. But Hari had full freedom so that he could pray to God anytime, and he also served other people. After a few days, Hari's father came to town to see him. Hari, here also you don't study anything. Do you know anything about the scriptures? Asked Hari's father. Okay. Yes, father, I know God is love and love is God. Loving everybody is loving God. God is present everywhere. So what is Hari doing there? He has got enough time in his uncle's house to pray and to help others. One day, when Hari's father came to see him, he saw that Hari was not studying anything. Instead, he was wasting his time. Okay? And his father is asking him, "Do you know anything about the scriptures?" And Hari is answering, "God is love, and loving everyone is God," said Hari. So his father wanted him to realize what is God. So that's why he is telling him that he wants to give him a challenge. Okay? So what was the challenge, children? Let us see. If love is God and love can do anything, can you make this dry tulsi plant fresh again? I shall give you a week's time to do so. Hari accepted the challenge happily and started worshipping the tulsi plant. So he is chanting some mantras to the tulsi tree and he started worshipping that tulsi plant. He watered the plant daily with love and respect and spoke to the tulsi plant for long hours. And 1 week passed by. So the people could not believe their eyes and said, "The tulsi plant looked so fresh with green fragrant leaves. It was a great miracle. It is Hari's prayer that has worked miracle and made the plant grow again." Okay, so can you understand the story? Let me tell you the story once for all. Okay, this story is about prayer. Okay, so I know all of you are praying daily, right? This story is about the power of prayer. Here, Hari was a little boy who lived in a village. Okay, he was a very good boy and he loved God so much and he used to pray daily and also help other people. Okay, what happened was his father was very disappointed with Hari's behavior. He thought Hari should become a scholar and he is sending Hari to his uncle's house. There, Hari is being given freedom to pray and to help other people. This made Hari's father little disappointed. So Hari's father is challenging him that, "Can you make this dried tulsi plant to grow again with the help of your prayers?" asked Hari's father. So Hari is accepting the challenge and he is watering the plant with due love and respect and also chanting mantras while watering the plants. 1 week passed by and the plants grew really well and everybody around him could not believe their eyes and said, "Hari's prayer has worked miracles." So children, when you pray with your heart and soul, God will definitely hear your prayers. So the moral of the story is sincere prayer can work miracles. So what is the moral of the story? Sincere prayer can work miracles. So children, you will have no question and answers from this lesson. So read the lesson once for all. Read it twice or thrice. I have sent you the PDF. So carefully read the lesson. So we'll do the activity. No need of marking the question and answers now. Okay? Read carefully each sentences written in the pots which show that you love or care for others. Use any color and color the pots. Okay? So you are going to read all the sentences that are written in the pots and show that you love or care for others. So first one is to drive away a stray dog. To help the poor. So what will you do? You are going to help the poor. So you are going to color the pot to help the poor. Then to listen to elders. So will you listen to your elders and your parents? Yes. So color this pot. To plant a tree. Yes, you should plant trees to get fresh air. So color this pot. To tear the petals of flower. So will you do that? No, you should not do. So don't color that. To help mummy clean up the house. Are you going to help your mothers? Yes. So color this. To throw toys about. Are you going to throw your toys here and there? No, you should never do that. Okay. To polish shoes. Yes, you're going to help your parents to polish your shoes, right? So you color this. To laugh at a lame man. So you should never laugh at people who are disabled, right? You should never do that. So don't color this. To throw stones at a squirrel. No, that's a very bad habit. You should never hurt plants and animals. To fight with classmates. Fighting is wrong. So you should never fight with your classmates. To take a blind person across the road. Yes, you should help the visually handicapped person to cross the road or help him with whatever he needs. Okay, children, are you happy to do this activity? Yes. So do this activity, right? So next lesson we are going to see. Now let's see what's the lesson. So how many of you obey your parents? All of you do obey your parents, right? But here is a story of a boy who is not obeying his father's words. And he is a devotee of Lord Vishnu. Okay. So let's see what happens in this story of Bhakta Prahlad. Okay. So do you know the story? We have enacted in our annual day function. Isn't it? Okay. So let us see Bhakta Prahlad. Okay. So it is a story about a small boy who is not obeying his father's words. Because he loves Lord Vishnu more than anything in the world. Okay. So let's see the story of Bhakta Prahlad. Hiranyakashipu was a great Asura king. He was evil minded and hated God. Hiranyakashipu was a great Asura king. He was evil-minded and hated God. Prahlad was his young son. Unlike his father, he loved Lord Vishnu and worshipped him. Hiranyakashipu put him to study in a Gurukul. Here, his teacher taught him to hate God and chant the name of his father Hiranyakashipu. When he returned to the palace, "You have been with the Guru for a long time. What did you learn?" "I have learned to worship Lord Vishnu," answers Prahlad. "Who taught you such things? Take him away. This boy must not live," asked Hiranyakashipu. Now, this Prahlad is being punished by his father. So first he is thrown into the sea by his father, but nothing happened to him. Second, he was rolled down the mountain, but he fell on a bed of roses and was saved. Third, poisonous snakes were sent towards him, but they did not harm him. And finally, Hiranyakashipu's sister Holika had a boon that she will not get burnt in fire. So she was ordered by the Asura king to burn Prahlad by keeping him on her lap. But not a hair of Prahlad got burnt. Instead, Holika was completely burnt. "You wicked one, why don't you die? What is the source of your power?" asked Hiranyakashipu. So Prahlad is answering that, "O father, it is Lord Vishnu. He is the source, not only of my power, but also yours. He is present everywhere." "Then, is he in the pillar?" asked Hiranyakashipu. So the Prahlad is answering. Saying so, Hiranyakashipu kicked the pillar with all his might. And Lord Vishnu, in the form of Narasimha, emerged from the pillar. He placed Hiranyakashipu on his lap, tore open his belly, and Hiranyakashipu died. Then Lord Vishnu blessed Prahlad for his firm faith in him. So the moral of the story is, firm faith in God can work miracles. Okay, so I'm going to tell you the story now. Okay, so this is a story of a little boy named Prahlad. Okay, so his father is a king of Asuras. What is his father's name? Hiranyakashipu. Now, Prahlad has been grown into a little boy. Okay, so Hiranyakashipu wanted him to join in Gurukul and learn all the Vedas. There, in the Gurukul, Prahlad was taught not to worship God, instead praise his father Hiranyakashipu. And once Hiranyakashipu realized that Prahlad loved Lord Vishnu more than anything, he is trying him to punish. So first, he is giving him a punishment to throw him in the sea. There, nothing happened to him. Later, he was rolled down the mountain from the mountain and he fell on a bed of flowers. So then Hiranyakashipu sent poisonous snakes towards Prahlada, but no snake had done any harm to him. Finally, he was very angry with Prahlad, so that he sent his sister Holika to make him sit on his lap so that he will get burnt in fire. But his sister Holika had get completely burnt in fire and Prahlad did not have any hurt. So this made Hiranyakashipu very much angry, and he asked Prahlad, "What is the spirit that is helping you?" And Prahlad answered, "Lord Vishnu is saving me." And then Hiranyakashipu asked, "Where is Vishnu?" He said, "He is present everywhere." He is asking, "Is he present in this pillar?" And Hiranyakashipu kicked the pillar with all his might. And
To his surprise, Lord Vishnu appeared in the form of Narasimha and killed Hiranyakashipu. And then Lord Vishnu blessed Prahlad for his sincere faith. And the moral of the story here is, firm faith in God can work miracles. Okay, children? So did you understand the two stories? Just go through the PDF, and if you have any doubts, please let me know. Okay, children? Thank you.